thanks for joining me at Vinyl Decal School. I'm so grateful that you're here and that you're watching my videos. And I'm so grateful to all of my subscribers and anyone who likes my videos, as it really gives me the motivation to keep going and to create more content like this. So this video was requested by Kirsty in my Facebook group. Thank you, Kirsty, for the idea. And it's a beginner's guide to advertising your vinyl decal business or your Etsy shop on Pinterest. So this is just a beginner's guide to getting traffic. I'm by no means an expert, but I have been using it for quite a few years now. And these are things I've done to drive traffic to my Etsy shops and websites and all different sorts of things in the past. If you want to take a deeper dive, there are more videos and mini courses and bloggers who cover all sorts of tips and stuff you can do. But I think a lot of this stuff can be quite trial and error. I've read a lot of those tips. Some things I implement work really well, and I've got pins that I pinned a few years ago. I still get traffic from those. And then pins I've spent ages making and they get no clicks through on at all. But I think that's probably the same for every kind of social media and marketing trick you try. It is sometimes just a bit of a risk and you've got to try it. But hopefully these next few tips can help you get the most out of Pinterest and get some more traffic to your business anyway. So if you've already got a Pinterest account, but it's full of recipes, home deco inspiration, outfits you want to try or buy, then I would personally start a new one specifically for your business. Unless maybe you've got like thousands of followers on your personal account, maybe then you should make anything that isn't relevant to your business, set that as a private board and then concentrate on your business from now on. But I personally would create a new one and always create a new one for each of my businesses. And now, I think this is like a fairly recent addition, you can actually switch between your accounts on the app and online. So if there's stuff you always save to your personal Pinterest page and you don't want to lose the ability to do that, it's really easy to switch between that and your business one now. So you don't need to worry about that. So open a new account if you need to, and then think about all of the things your customer might be interested in. So I'm just using my Vinyl Decal School Pinterest here as an example, although it's fairly new. And you can see here I've started pinning things to do with Cricut, Silhouette, making decals, running a business. And you can just search for those things in the search bar to pin them. You want to be pinning like 80% other people's content, 20% your own roughly. I think that's what they say. This is more informative for your customer, more interesting. Helps you show up in searches better, and it just generally looks less spammy. And then as you're saving each pin, set up boards for each different category and make the title of the board something someone might search for, as you can see I've done here for lots of mine. On my other Pinterest page, which is wedding specific, I've had it a lot longer, so it's a lot more organized and it's got a lot more content on there. So I made these covers for each of the different boards so that it looked neater. And you can do that in Canva, which I will show a little bit later in the video. If this is already sounding like a lot and you're like, oh, I don't really have time to be pinning all the time, like other people's content and my own content, then Tailwind is like your best friend for this kind of thing. I've got a link in the description so you can get a free month trial. Even if you just take that one free month to get yourself started and get loads of content onto your Pinterest page. I did stop paying for it towards the end of last year as I was using it mostly for my wedding Pinterest, but I'm not really doing as much wedding stuff anymore, so I don't have it at the minute, but I definitely want to get it again for Vinyl Decal School Pinterest as I build this YouTube channel up and trying to do more with my courses and SVG design, stuff like that. So it lets you just upload images straight in, or you can go to Pinterest, and if you get the Tailwind button on your browser, you can pin stuff from Pinterest, but also everywhere online, basically. Or they also give you these handy suggestions of things you can add. And it's basically like a schedule, so they'll pick all of the best times that you should add pins. You can add, remove time slots, and then just schedule it up, and then that many pins will be pinned for you automatically during the week. And the best bit about Tailwind though is the community section. So you can join 5 communities under all sorts of different categories. Look for the ones with the most members and the highest activity. And what you do is you basically add your pins so other people can repin them, but then it also gives you loads of other people's content that you can then pin in return. And you can also create your new community as well if you need to. Once your Pinterest is open, you're starting to add content, kind of getting in a routine of adding things your customers want to see. You also need to change it to a business account. This is how you do that. So it's really easy. You go to your profile and under account settings, just scroll all the way down, and then it's under account changes. You just convert your personal account to a business one. This lets you check your analytics and check which pins are performing the best so you can recreate that type of pin in future. So you're pinning loads of other people's content, but obviously the reason you're here is you want to get traffic to your own Etsy shop or website, or even your Instagram or Facebook. So the easiest thing to do is to just pin straight from one of those sites. And once your pin is on Pinterest, then it should link back to whatever that site is once someone clicks on it. So this is how you do that. Make sure your Pinterest account is signed into the right account. Go on the picture you want to pin, and there should be a button that comes up in the left-hand corner on Etsy anyway. Scroll down to the board you want to add it to. I'm going to add this to Valentine's Day ideas, and then save, and it's as easy as that. And I think with some items, this works really well if it's a really good photo or if it's something quite unique. But if you're selling a vinyl decal, for example, you kind of want people to know that it's a vinyl decal and that's what they're going to be getting once they click through. And that means you get the right kind of customers as well. Also, long pins tend to do better than wide pins. So I probably wouldn't pin this one, for example. And if this is the case for a lot of your products, then you can make your own pins on Canva. So you can do this with your phone or iPad, but I'm just going to do it on my laptop because I find it easier. If you search for Pinterest pin, a load of different templates will come up. So some of them will be video pins like this one here, but I'm just going to look for one that shows off a few different pictures like this one. So open it up, and then to change all of the wording, you just click on it and you can just type in new wording, and then once you're happy with it, you can change the fonts and the size. Try and do like a title that is going to grab your customers' attention and is going to tell them what your item's about, what it is. Give them a bit more information basically. And make it really like bright and easy to read. I always add my business name on as well, just in case it gets repinned, they can find their way back to me and my business. Then if you go on to upload media, you can upload some of the photos of your products, add them in there, get a nice range, make sure they're centered and it's really clear what they are. Change the colours as well to fit your branding or to fit a theme. Once you're happy, download it as a PNG file. Then go to Pinterest and create a pin, drag the picture in there, and then add a title. Again, trying to be really clear with what the item is, but also thinking about what people are going to be searching for and what might make it come up in searches. Again, same for the description. And you can add hashtags here as well that are relevant to what you're trying to sell. I'm just doing this really quickly, so I'm sure you can come up with better hashtags than me. Do a bit more research. Then add an alt text in as well, which is just what the photo is, but gives you another chance for SEO. Then for the destination link, you want to link back to your product. So I'm going to do my whole Valentine's Day collection and use the link from there, but you could do a single product as well. add it in there, and then find the board you want to add it to. I've already got Valentine's Day cricket ideas set up. I'm going to publish it to there, and then that's your Canva pin post. Or of course, add them to Tailwind to schedule if you're using that. So as I've said, this is just a quick beginner's guide. There's loads more you can deep dive into how to get Pinterest to work for you. And stuff is changing all the time. Like, I think they're trying to get more people to do video pins now. So if you've got lots of videos of your process, working them into a pin or just pin them directly could be something you could do. But as I said before as well, it's basically trial and error. Pin stuff you like, try different colours of pins, types of pins. And I don't think I've mentioned it yet, but Pinterest is actually technically a search engine like Google rather than a social media platform like Facebook or Instagram. So just bear in mind when you're pinning things, think, how is this answering someone's question or solving a problem? When you're making your title, think, what are people going to be searching for on Pinterest that will make my picture stand out and pop up? Hope that's helpful. Anyway, it's given you a little bit of a start with Pinterest. If you've got any questions, let me know in the comments. But otherwise, please subscribe and like this video so I can continue to make more content like this in future.